This and the one thing I always like to say to people is that, you know, when I come on, sometimes it seems like doom and gloom, but remember, as an investor, there are always opportunities out there. So
in his latest interview with David Lin, investor and trader Gareth Soloway is talking about his current market outlook for Bitcoin and the technical situation in the charts. He is sharing his price levels for Bitcoin and why he is currently very cautious. Gareth reveals his important Bitcoin bottom signal and why it is so important to be patient and disciplined. In the second half of the video, Gareth shares his view on the traditional stock market and his opinion on the interest rate cycle. We will bring you the highlights of his interview, so make sure to stick around to the end of the video to get the best insights. If you enjoy crypto and finance content, consider subscribing and liking the video.
I think the key to recognize is that's kind of the unlikely scenario, but if we were to get into a cataclysmic collapse in the equity markets, in the Bitcoin and the crypto markets, then that likely would be the bottom. And the reason I came to that conclusion is essentially during the dot-com era, Amazon dropped 95% from its highs before obviously recovering to the record levels that it hit over the last couple of years. So that 95% mapped out to Bitcoin would bring us back to about 3,500. Now, for me, that's not really the likely scenario. I'm at a 12 to 13,000 high-end target with a low-end target of 9,000. But I'd just like to show you here, this is the chart of Bitcoin. And what we can see very clearly here is that we've had a big rally. A lot of people, like if you go on Twitter, they'll say, oh, it's the bottom. We're going to start a new bull market. I disagree. If you look at this M pattern, look at the M pattern. The second portion of the M is higher than the first. Now let's go back to the all-time highs on Bitcoin and look at that pattern. This is a classic topping pattern. So for me, what we've seen recently is actually a bear market rally. We've now come off of that 25,000 retrace with a bear flag. We then dropped, and we're now bear flagging with a likely downside move to at least 18,000 and change. And ultimately, I do think that we're going to see 12 to 13 and eventually 9. And think about this, right? You're in a scenario where if I'm correct that the economy is going to go into recession, then you're looking at the stock market probably with another 25 to 30% down from here on the S&P 500. Now, tell me how Bitcoin doesn't go lower if the S&P drops 25 to 30%. They're saying that generally the Bitcoin bear market, 2 years, give or take a little bit, like you're saying. And the issue here that I have with that is that, number one, we don't have a lot of historical bear markets in Bitcoin, 2-3 bear markets since Bitcoin's inception. The other issue is that if you look at when we came out of that bear market in 2019 to 2020, it coincided with the COVID collapse, which then triggered the Federal Reserve to print more money than we have ever seen printed in history. And so the question is we're now in this new environment where I think it doesn't mean that the cycle won't play out exactly like it has. It just means we have to, as investors, take that into account that there is no printing of money going on from the Fed and interest rates are a lot higher. So there is a precedent now that if you map that out, the Bitcoin bear market could even last a little bit longer, much like the stock market bear market. Couple positions short in crypto right now, and I do have a little Bitcoin on the long side as well. So I'm a little hedged. I'm kind of short alts right now versus being slightly long Bitcoin. But the key is this, is it's a very, very small, very, very small position. And what I want people to understand is that you can still accumulate in this lower range. I'm still a huge long-time bull or long-term bull on Bitcoin. I still think it's going much, much higher than even 69,000. It's just you have to give it enough time to kind of digest what the Fed is doing and kind of cycle out all the weak hands. So again, for me, it's just going to be continuing to accumulate. We get to 15, we get to 13, we get to 10, to 5. I will continue to kind of accumulate with a long-term view, but I'm not going to be someone that's chasing it at 25,000 on a pop here. I want to be patient. I want to be disciplined. And that's really what traders are going to be, right? If you're a successful trader, you are uber, uber disciplined. Patience is the hardest thing to be. And the beauty of it is this, right? Is that I've been wrong on trades before. I've been wrong on many. But the key is that what I always understand as a technical trader is that if I miss one today and I'm wrong on it, there's always another one tomorrow. And that's the beauty of trading gold and silver and Bitcoin and ETH and stocks. And I mean, there's just so many things to trade that who cares if I miss one? Heck, I miss them every day. All you got to do is capture one or two here and there and you become a millionaire. Things that I would look for is all out panic, which we haven't seen. Even when FTX collapsed, you didn't get a crazy amount of panic. You still had a lot of bulls that were still ready to say, no, don't worry, this is going to be fine. It was kind of the closest thing to that, which did mark a short-term low. But I still think you have to get to a point where, like in 2019, when we were at the lows, I still vividly remember you know, CNBC had talked about Bitcoin every day, and they had the ticker of what the Bitcoin price was every single day. And by 2018 into 19 in the bear market, they took it away and they never talked about it. And that was a signal to start accumulating. So essentially, when everyone else turns ugly bearish, where they're starting to write it off, that's when an investor like myself starts to inch in. I also think you look for technical levels like the pierce of 10,000 to the 9,000 target. Think about how many stops will be right at that 10,000 level that'll get wiped out. You'll see major panic below 10,000 because it breaks the even number. Those are the signals that I kind of pay attention to. Definitely spot. I like being in the pure form of it. I like owning Bitcoin itself. That makes me feel more comfortable. The futures, again, you get the rollovers of the contracts and other things like that. So for me, I'm just a pure form, you know, on the spot. We've now seen this sideways chop. And if, again, look at that. Really, the low here, I mean, you briefly violated it in October. But aside from that, you've been going sideways for a long period of time. Now, when you're a technician like myself, you start to recognize that a pattern like this is what we call a wedge pattern, right? And there's a defined wedge pattern here that unfortunately is more of a bearish wedge, right? You have a down move and then the wedge of consolidation is occurring here. So to me, it's a matter of time until the next leg comes in here. We're seeing the dollar pop today. That could be a headwind if the dollar continues to strengthen, as it's telling us the Fed may continue to raise rates. But bottom line is, investors should be very, very careful. I myself am mostly short at this point in time. You're in this wedge pattern. If we were to break above this wedge pattern, you'd have to assume this is the beginning of a move up. It doesn't mean we're going back to all-time highs, but we're likely going up to this 4320 level on the S&P 500. So really, once you're above this yellow trend line, that would be where you would say, okay, you now have to exercise that mental stop or physical stop and exit the position. But right now, again, notice we're having a nice little down day. We're hammering on this trend line. If this trend line breaks, this is where the next leg lower should kick in. And ultimately, I think I still have it pinned in that we're going down to pre-COVID levels on the S&P 500. That's around 3375 and potentially as low as 33,000 on the S&P. It's partially technical and it's also psychological, right? So you've been in this bear market for a long period of time. We've seen big names like the GameStops and the AMCs run. We've seen Coinbase have big moves. And so there's this kind of psychological want from investors that they want to see the revisiting of the craziness of 2021. The problem is, the differences are enormous. You don't have the government sending out checks. You don't have interest rates at zero. You don't have massive quantitative easing. And so you're getting these kind of buy the dip mentalities of coming back in, hoping that the bottom is in. The problem is, and by the way, the bottom being in is being driven by a narrative that the Fed is getting close to halting their hikes and actually lowering rates. I disagree with that. I think they are getting close to the end of the rate hike cycle. I just don't think that they're ready to lower rates, especially with some of the inflation data that we've seen recently. So we'll probably see a 25 basis point hike in the next couple of weeks from the Fed when they have their, I think it's March 22nd meeting. But ultimately, the big kicker here is that you're going to see 5% interest rates for a long period of time. The Fed has made it clear they don't want to repeat the issues that Paul Volcker met in the 80s. And that's going to be what's going to really drive the economy into a recession. Totally new environment, right? We've been addicted. It's an economy, an investable market that's been addicted to interest rates. In fact, it's so crazy. Like if you talk to economists, if you talk to investors, what do they say? They say, oh, don't worry. If we go into a recession, the Federal Reserve will print money to get us out. Think about that statement. You're basically saying that the economy can't get us out of a recession by itself without the help of printing of money. And that's ludicrous, but that's the situation that we're in right now. So you have to be on the awareness side that at this stage, the Fed is going to be very nervous. They've been bitten by the inflation bug. Remember, they said transitory. It was anything but transitory. And that's going to make it a situation where they're going to be very reluctant to lower rates unless inflation goes below 2%. And I don't have that penciled in for multiple years. So what is that going to mean? It's going to mean we're going to slip into a recession. Essentially, they're not going to lower rates to get us out. They're not going to print money to get us out for a longer period of time. And that puts us in a potential recessionary period for 2 to 3 years at minimum. The recession is going to be a slow rolling recession. It's going to be one like the lobster in the hot water. And I hate to use that kind of imagery, but ultimately where it slowly heats up. And I think initially people are going to say, okay, it's not really going to be that bad. And the Fed probably calms us down by saying, oh, it's not going to be that bad, just like they said it was going to be transitory on inflation. So they have a tendency to understate what's going to ultimately happen. And investors have to be prepared on the other side for something much, much worse. But because it's going to last so long, it's going to continually get worse and worse and worse. But the Fed is unlikely to come to the rescue, at least for the first 12 months of this recession, due to inflation's high levels. So that's going to make it, by the end of this recession, it is going to be nasty. And I think we could be, and I said this before with you as well, I'm looking at no new highs on the S&P 500 for 10 to 15 years. I think that we're in a recessionary period for at minimum 2 to 3 years, and it could even be dragged out longer. Eventually, unemployment goes so high that even if inflation is 3%, the Fed will come to the rescue eventually and stimulate. Remember that the Fed actually lowered interest rates following the dot-com collapse, and we didn't see technology stocks, the NASDAQ, hitting new highs for really 15 to 16 years. So again, I think the issue too in this scenario is that you're going to see them starting to print or lower interest rates, and then it's going to create a bigger inflation concern, right? So if you don't get inflation back into the box and close that box tight, you're going to have the stimulus creating this fear or reality of higher inflation for longer periods of time. And this is going to be a battle that the Fed is going to wage for years to come against inflation. If you think about it, look at how long we've been in a market with underinflation, with sub 2%. Well, you know what? When you're sub for a period of time, it's likely that you'll be over to even it out for a period of time. And that's going to make it so when you have inflation high, it's going to be very hard for the consumer to really continue to spend at the levels they are able to or they want to before, obviously, the markets get back to all-time highs.
Thank you for watching. Check out the next video to get more insights into the crypto markets.